This example says that in the circuit shown in figure, we are required to find the value of resistance R at which the power transferred to this resistance will be maximum. Now, in this situation, if we just have a look on the circuit carefully, here we can remove this resistance R across the terminals A and B, and we just transform the remaining circuit between the points A and B by a single equivalent battery by using Thevenin's method. If we just redraw the circuit, it will look like the situation. This 5 ohm resistance, this 20 volt, this 4 ohm. Here it is a 10 volt battery, this 6 ohm resistance, this terminal A. Now we have removed the variable resistance R. And here a 10 volt battery is connected. Now in this situation, if we calculate the internal resistance of the circuit between points A and B, then here you can see this RAB is equals to a value such that all the batteries we can replace by their equivalent resistance or internal resistance. Here as batteries are ideal, we can replace these by straight wires. Then you can see, after replacing batteries by straight wire, this 4 ohm resistance will come in parallel with the 6 ohm resistance. And this combination is in series combination with 5 ohm resistance across terminals A and B. So we can say the internal resistance across A and B for the circuit is, this internal resistance RAB we can write as this 4 ohm in parallel combination with the 6 ohm, and this group is in series combination with the 5 ohm resistance. So here 4 and 6 ohm when taken in parallel, this will be 4 multiplied by 6 by 4 plus 6 in series with 5 ohm. So this will be plus 5, and here you can see this will be 24 by 10, this 2.4 plus 5, that is equals to 7.4 ohm. So this internal resistance of the circuit will be 7.4 ohm. That means the circuit can be redrawn like this. Say if these are terminals A and B, there will be an equivalent EMF. Here if we need to find just the value of R, we don't need to calculate the open circuit potential difference for the equivalent battery. We have just calculated the internal resistance, which is 7.4 ohm. It is connected across A and B, and this will be some equivalent EMF. And now if we just place this resistance back between A and B, this was the resistance R, then in this situation we can directly state for maximum power to be transferred to R using maximum power transfer theorem, we have the direct value of R should be equals to 7.4 ohm. That will be the answer to this problem, because by maximum power transfer theorem we can state that in the external resistance power will be maximum when the value of external resistance is equal to the internal resistance of the circuit. So in this situation you can see, just as we have calculated the internal resistance, the value of external resistance must be equal to internal resistance, and that's why I have not calculated the value of E equivalent, which is not required here, because it is just asking the value of R for which the power transferred to it will be maximum.